In matters of foreign policy, President Marcos reveals his administration may continue to file diplomatic protests against China if incursions and alleged harassment of Filipino fishermen persist. The latest harassment of a Filipino boat by a Chinese Coast Guard occurred near Ayungin Shoal. Marcos says he does not see the need for the Chinese to shadow Filipino fisher folk since the fishing vessels do not pose a threat to anyone.
Does not preclude us from continuing to make protests and continuing to send note verbals concerning this. But, this is a long process because it is something new. I just hope we can come to some kind of arrangement.
In a statement, the Foreign Affairs Department also asserts Filipino fishermen are free to exercise their rights in the Ayungin Shoal without any intervention from another country, since the area is part of the country's exclusive economic zone. It adds diplomatic action on the incident will be undertaken after Philippine authorities file their official reports. The Philippine Coast Guard also allaying fears of Filipino fishermen. PCG Commandant Admiral Artemio Abu tells them they should continue fishing in the West Philippine Sea. He also assured them of government protection. But he's hoping for more talks between the Philippines and China to address maritime issues.
The Coast Guard is closely monitoring what's happening to our fishermen in the area. Mm-hmm. The reports we received that they are being overshadowed by China Coast Guard. Mm-hmm. The Coast Guard has responded positively to that. Mm-hmm. We are currently deploying our assets and intensifying our presence. We really need to coordinate well with the national leadership. Our government has to coordinate well with Chinese government. It has to be communicated down to the front lines, not just a high level talks with the people on top the hierarchy of the leadership.
The Philippine government looking to hire a private firm to manage traffic at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. President Marcos says he and other government officials already met with the company during their trip to New York last year. He adds that company was in Manila last week to inspect the operations in the country's main gateway.
The group that runs Gatwick Airport, they run London Airport, they run several big airports. That we're asking them, what can they do? Can they come in and help us so that we can increase the traffic through the Manila Airport? And they say that they, without changing anything, without new equipment, without building a new runway, that they can increase the traffic from what is presently, they refer to as 35 movements per hour to up to 45 movements per hour without changing anything. So we want that.
The foreign firm's visit follows the New Year's Day air travel mess that affected over 65,000 passengers.